Greetings, brothers and sisters. God bless each and every one of you today. I hope everybody's doing well. Today's message is titled, "The Mockers and Scoffers Are Fulfilling Bible Prophecy." You know, it's amazing right now when you talk about Jesus coming back at any moment to rapture his church. When you flat out just tell people that Jesus is coming soon, what's the typical reply that you're going to get? Mostly from unbelievers, but also from even most professing Christians. You're going to get responses typical to this. Every generation has been saying that Jesus is coming, and he hasn't come yet. Things are going to continue as they always have. We're going to get through this. A lot of times people say, oh, maybe 100 years from now, or in the next generation, or, you know, in another lifetime. Right? Does that sound pretty familiar? It should, because in the book of 2 Peter, chapter 3, verse 3 to 4, all right, look at what Peter says here. "Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers, walking after their own lusts, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation." I mean, you just look around right now, and you watch the normal person's response when you say Jesus is coming soon. Again, whether it's an unbeliever or even right now a lot of even professing Christians, right? That's going to be their response. I wanted to share with you a portion of my article I had done over at Harbingers Daily. Again, if you go to harbingersdaily.com, you can find all their resources and articles. It's a great source, I believe, so definitely go check them out, harbingersdaily.com. And if you just search my name, Chad Thomas, you'll find all my articles that they've published of mine. But I want to share one that was published titled, "Mockers and Scoffers Are Fulfilling Bible Prophecy." Let me read some of it to you. "Just walk up to a majority of professing Christians or unbelievers mentioning anything about the Lord's return and watch the response you're going to get. Most likely you will get a weird look and they will say something like, every generation has been saying that Jesus is coming, and he hasn't come. Things will keep going as they always have." Don't forget this. "In Noah's day, people seeing the construction of the ark would have scoffed at him, thinking, look at this clown and his family. What a bunch of fools. Noah preached for 120 years. Then suddenly, the flood came, overtaking the world. Only Noah and his house, which was consisting of 8 people, and the animals that accompanied them were spared. In Lot's day, the angels hastened Lot and his family to escape Sodom and Gomorrah due to the impending destruction of the cities. We then learn that when Lot told his 2 sons-in-law of the coming judgment, they mocked him." You can read about that in Genesis 19:14. "In both cases, we can clearly see that when the warnings went out, Noah and Lot were met with ridicule, then sudden destruction came. Fast forward thousands of years, and here we are in what I believe is the terminal generation before the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The signs are all there. Millions upon millions of believers worldwide have family members, friends, and co-workers that will mock and scoff at them when they mention the Lord's return. To reiterate, the world mocked Noah, they mocked Lot, and they will mock us. The Bible does not lie. Today, people will, almost to a T, repeat precisely what's recorded in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 3 to 4. So rather than getting discouraged because of the mocking and scoffing many of you are enduring, especially from those that are closest to us, be encouraged that they are fulfilling Bible prophecy. What they are doing is actually showing us how close we are to Jesus coming for his bride. Again, it's time for us to stand strong for Jesus. It's time for us not to lose boldness. The Bible clearly tells us that we will see the day approaching. And if we are watching, that day will not catch us off guard like a thief in the night. Unfortunately, for a majority of the world, the Lord's return will catch them totally off guard. Ezekiel 33 tells us when we see a sword coming, we are to warn the people. It's very evident that the tribulation period is coming, and it's coming fast. Jesus will snatch his true children off those train tracks before sudden impact. Until that day, let the mockers and the scoffers do what they do best as they are fulfilling Bible prophecy. Now, I want to make it clear, I believe 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 3 to 4, all right? That's going to continue to be filled throughout the seven-year tribulation period, again, until the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, when Jesus touches down on the Mount of Olives to establish his millennial kingdom. But I believe we're starting to see it form right now, because you mention anything about the Lord's imminent return to rapture his church to unbelievers, or again, even many professing believers, all right, they're going to give you that look, and they're going to say, where is the promise of his coming? Repeating exactly what's recorded in the book of 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 3 to 4. Every generation's been saying that, man. Things are going to continue on as usual like they always have. Quit the nonsense, you clown. But if you're one of those people that's saying, every generation's been saying Jesus is coming and nothing's happened, things are going to continue on like normal, stay tuned for my next video after that. If you're somebody that's doubting. Because the next video I'm going about to share should convince you 100% of the times that we're living in. But folks, again, don't be discouraged. Again, they mock Noah, they mock Lot, and they're going to mock us. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep planting the seeds. Keep giving people the gospel of their salvation. Again, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 1 to 4. Tell them right now it's time to repent, which means metanoia, which means to change their mind. Right? They need to change their mind about who God is. They need to go from unbelief right now, dead in their sins, to belief, a new creature in Christ. Right? They need to agree with God right now about their sin condition, that they're sinners in need of a Savior, that they can't save themselves, that Jesus Christ did it all for them on the cross of Calvary by shedding his precious blood. And right here and right now, they need to put their faith and their trust and believe that Jesus Christ died on that cross for their sins. He was buried and he resurrected on the third day, as it is written in the scriptures. We need to tell people that yes, Jesus is coming, and he's coming any moment to rapture his church. We need to tell people that Jesus Christ is the only way to the kingdom of heaven, and he's the only name that's going to save them. And again, we need to tell them that they can be saved right here, right now, this very moment. Again, it's not about religion. It's about them believing, putting their faith and their trust in the blood of Jesus. Again, explain to them that Jesus Christ became sin for us on that cross at Calvary, shedding his precious blood, paying that sin debt in full that we can never pay on our own, so we can be forgiven of our sin and be with him forever. But again, it's about telling them, it's about believing what Jesus did for them on that cross at Calvary, believing he died for their sins on that cross, paying their sin debt in full. He was buried, and he resurrected on the third day, as it is written in the scriptures. Keep watching with me. Keep looking up. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Son of God, Jesus Christ, he's coming, and he's coming quickly. God bless you all.